Welcome, bot builders. This is Arin from Botpress, and today I'll be showing you how to build a chatbot for Telegram in just 5 easy steps. Today, I'm building a Telegram chatbot using Botpress. This bot will act like a real assistant. It will respond in a human tone, understand your business, and answer questions naturally. No scripts, just smart replies powered by AI. So it's perfect for small businesses like travel agencies, beauty salons. You can use it to handle questions about tours, pricing, availability, or booking directly inside Telegram. I'll show you how to build this step by step. So without wasting any more time, let us just hop right into it. Before I get into building, let me quickly show you what the final chatbot will look like. And this over here is a dummy deployment of the chatbot, so we can start the conversation by a simple start. And let's just wait for the chatbot to reply. So I have named my chatbot Wandery. Wandery Adventures is the name of the dummy company that we are building the chatbot for. So we can ask it a question regarding a tour. So let us just ask it a question like, do you have any tours leaving for Greece? So that should go ahead and prompt the chatbot to look into the information that it already has about some of my upcoming events. And that returns this event, which has a package name, destination, duration, all this other stuff. Okay, let us ask it another question, which will be more context driven and more targeted at its knowledge solving skills. Since it says that the departure city is LA, why not ask it something like, do you have any more tours leaving from the West Coast? And let's see what we get in a reply for that. Okay. It understood the assignment pretty well. It understood that LA and San Francisco, both of them are on the West Coast, so it listed you both the trips that are leaving from there. That's pretty much it for what we are building today. The main objective of the tutorial is to build a beginner-friendly FAQ chatbot and deploy it on Telegram in just 5 easy steps. So let me go ahead and quickly show you how it can be done. Alright guys, so let us go ahead and start building the chatbot. The first thing that you would like to do is create your bot. This is the overall scaffolding for your chatbot that will be actually talking to users on Telegram. So to do that, head over to Botpress and create a new bot. You can go ahead and choose a name for this bot. Naming a bot clearly helps with tracking its purpose and overall conversations later on, in case you have a very diverse range of bots working on different things. But I think we can just let this be. You can see I have 3-4 bots already and I don't know what they do. Go ahead and name your bots. So while we wait for the bot to commence, there are 2-3 things that I would like you to start thinking about your bot. These are things that will help define your bot's purpose, what you are getting out of it. You could ask yourself questions like, who is your audience? What should the bot help with? Don't make it too overly diverse. Keep it simple to FAQ, booking, and dealing with appointments first, and then build upon it. So now once we are inside the studio, let us go ahead and first ignore everything over here and add a knowledge base to the thing. I'll get to the instructions in a sec, but I think it's easier to explain the instructions better when I have all the documents that I want my chatbot to know about already uploaded. So knowledge bases, for people who are new to the concept, is external knowledge that helps your chatbot that is working using LLMs to single out, bring down its scope from overall generalized things about the entire world to your business use case. So adding a document like that helps it ground its knowledge to what your standards are. So I'll go ahead and add a file which will have all these frequently asked questions regarding my business, answering queries regarding billing or refunds or overall what are the next steps to take. So let's go ahead and add that file over here. I'll show you how this file looks like. So you can also go ahead and build a file like this. Don't overcomplicate this file. So overall, general chatbots know a lot more about things than you might give them credit for. But for the sake of my chatbot, I have added questions like, how can I book a trip? What is your refund policy? This is a very detailed explanation of my refund policy, complete with dates and percentage and all these things that you want your chatbot to be accurate about. So once you upload something like this, information can be treated as an overall static information that is in your knowledge base, which will not be changing a lot. So you don't need to upload it again and again. You don't need to change it a lot. And that brings me to the second type of information that you can add to your knowledge base. The second type of information that we are going to be adding to our knowledge base is a table. Adding a table gives you more room to test out dynamic information while feeding data into the chatbot. So what do I mean by dynamic information? Well, basically, it can have something like the tours. As I mentioned earlier, we are building a chatbot for a travel agency. So tours is one thing that can be changing a lot. The pricing can be changing. The due dates, the hotels, the country, departure location, arrival location. So to do that, to make it easier, we can make it into a table, which allows us to go and change just one row without touching the entire data. So let us go ahead and import our new table, which has all this information already. So I'll go ahead and do that. The table that I'm uploading has information like the package name, destination, country, price per person, tags, departure city, and whether the visa is required or not from USA. So let's go continue, and we're going to import it. Once the import job is completed, I think we can go back to knowledge bases and include this table as part of the knowledge base. So you can do that very easily by that. And yep, that's pretty much it. So that brings us to the next step in our process, which is going to be adding instructions to the chatbot. As I mentioned earlier, after having the knowledge base already integrated, it's much easier to guide your chatbot to information that you wanted to refer to or a specific style that you wanted to reply in. For our instruction, I already have a prompt, but I'll show you what I have covered in it. Okay, so my instruction starts with Wanderly, a helpful virtual assistant for a travel agency. This entire document contains instructions regarding not inventing, assuming any information. Always strictly use entries from the table that is provided for the events. Do not offer or promise anything that isn't clearly listed. Some chatbots might try to offer special discounts to your users without, because they have seen other chatbots do that in the data that they have trained on. We can put in some instructions like this to ground the behavior a lot more and ensuring that our model is not misbehaving. So once you have instructions like this, you can go ahead and save it. And there you have it. The chatbot logic already exists. So now we just need to get a Telegram facing entry point for the users to interact with it. Without waiting further, let us head over to Telegram and create the front end for this chatbot. All right. Once we are in Telegram, what you would like to do first is create a bot using Botfather. People who are new to Telegram should know that Telegram has a very tight-knit connection with bots. The entire stack is very bot-friendly. They have their own version of letting users onboard a bot very easily. You can just go ahead and search Botfather. Should start the bot. So what you can do first is start a conversation with it. Immediately you see that if you're new to bot API, see the manual. But what we should do first is create a new bot. And that prompts you to select a name for the new bot. When they're talking about the name of the new bot, this is the name that you want your bot to appear as. So I want my bot to appear as Wanderly. And you can press enter. The next thing that it will ask you is, what is the username for the bot? And now you can see that it asks you to mention bot specifically. So you can add something like Wanderly bot. And oh, that username is already taken. So Wanderly bot. So that should just give you a bot token, which you can go ahead and just copy. So I'll just copy this. And now I'll show you how, using this token, you can connect your Botpress bot to Telegram. So let's head over back to Botpress. So once you're in Botpress, you can go down to communication channels, select Telegram, and install the integration. Okay, so once the integration has been installed, you can go ahead and add the token that we just copied, and that should immediately connect our bot to the Telegram interface. And once the configuration has been saved, you can close it, and we can finally publish it. And maybe we can go back to Telegram and try to have a conversation with this new bot. Okay, let's wait for a sec. Oh, okay, so it's receiving the messages already. I'm orderly. Okay, awesome. Hey, can I know about the trips that are leaving for Europe for less than $1,000? You can now start asking it very specific questions. I invite you to go ahead and experiment with different type of questions a user might throw at it. Some things that you know has broken your earlier systems before, or your own customer service may struggle with. So go ahead and ask those queries. And that's it. You have just built a fully functional AI-powered Telegram chatbot for a travel agency using Botpress. It can answer real questions from documents, pull live data from a table, talk to users like a human, all without writing a single line of code. If you want to expand from here, you can always add booking flows. I'll be adding a link to a booking chatbot video that we released 2 weeks ago. So you can go ahead and check that out. If you want to know how you can bring something like Calendly to Botpress and automate your booking up process through that. And you'll very soon see that your bot is getting very good at answering these FAQs and handling your customers. So if this tutorial helped, drop your questions below. If you're building something cool, I'd love to hear about it. See you in the next one. Until then, happy bot building.